Hi everybody, it's Diane, and I just wanted to share the note cards that I made for the May swap over at yourpaperpantry.ning.com, and the theme for May is masculine note card, and the sentiment you could leave blank this month or add something that you'd like. So if anybody's interested, we have plenty of room, and the great thing about this note card swap is that it is not your typical 3x3. You can, but measurements can range anywhere from 3 3/4 to 3 3/4 or below. So you can make your cards 2x3, 3x3, whatever size you like, and also whatever shape you would like. So it's a fun swap. If you're looking for some masculine cards, this would be the month to join. If you're like me, I never have a masculine card on hand, and it would be great to have some on hand. The note card here that I made is measurements is 3 3/4 by 3 3/4. I did want to make it a little bit bigger than the typical 3x3. I thought it would be great so that if I have a gift that I need to give with, usually, especially for men, I will put it in like a little bag there, you know, a gift bag. And so instead of worrying about going out and buying a card, I have these note cards and I'll have some on hand. So they really are perfect for that. And so this is what I came up with. This is, and I'll tell you a little bit what I did. See if you can see that better. And then the inside I just lined with white, and I use the Always Artichoke ink from Stampin' Up, and that's the color of this background paper that I used. And I used the old technique using masking tape. Probably about 10 years ago or so, I was a demonstrator for a little while, and I remembered this technique that we did way back when, and I dug out one of my cards and thought, you know, I really need to do this for this month's card. So I will show you what I used. I used the ultra thick embossing powder, and I used some masking tape, which I thought was perfect for a masculine card. And then I use this stamp here, and I love these stamps. This is a Studio 112 stamp that I got from Joann's. I love their stamps, the Studio 112 stamps. They are so intricate. The detail is amazing. I just love them, and for a buck, you can't go wrong. So I got that, and then let me show you an old card. This is from, like I said, it was like 10 years ago, I think, I made this. I took off the front because I wanted to show you this was on here like this, but and I never did get to finish it embellishing it. But anyway, I just wanted to show you this part here. What you do is you take your masking tape and you just rip it in pieces and put it all over your mat. And then you take your ink and you rub your ink all over it, and it will get on all the edges. And then what you do is you take your embossing powder and you emboss the whole thing. Now, this one was done with a fine embossing powder, and that's why you can really see the tape a lot more in this one. Now, the card that I made, the masculine card here with the deer on it, it's really, really glossy, the background, because I used the ultra thick embossing powder, and I did it 2 times. So it's really shiny. It really looks like glossy accents along the whole thing, but you still can see in the background the technique of the ripped paper, which is the masking tape. And then I just put a little bit of, I didn't have any jute, but I have a whole bunch of burlap. So I peeled off the burlap and used that to tie around here. So anyway, that is my cards for the swap this month, the May swap over at yourpaperpantry.ning.com. I hope you are inspired to join us. We have a lot of fun, and I also did wind up making my envelope because I needed a 4x4 size so that it would fit nice and snug, and it would fit nice in there without being snug. So anyway, there's my envelope. And I'm really enjoying my envelope punch to make those. So anyway, if you have any questions, feel free to ask. And come on over and join us at yourpaperpantry.ning.com. Ta-ta for now.